everybody. Welcome back to Cat Family Adventures. Another change. We are at the Ontario Convention Center and we are here for the Great Homeschool Convention. So I'm here to show you around the convention. Also, they'll kind of go over some misconceptions about homeschooling and just kind of share a little bit about it. So come with us as we check it out. This is one of our favorite things to do every single year, and so we can't wait to show you.
Come on, everybody. Here we go.
So every year they do a Thursday night free shopping. So if you don't want to come to the convention but want to check out the hall with all the vendors, then you can come for free on Thursday night.
So when I mentioned at the beginning that when we went to France, we were reading books about the French Revolution from like the perspective of, I think it was like a 12-year-old boy. It's really good.
Virginia City. Learn
So there are some major homeschool curriculum companies, like this is Sunlight, and then I will show you the other larger companies that they have, but then they also have smaller companies that sell their curriculum, so it can be a little overwhelming. So you just need to take it step by step and kind of get all the information. They're obviously, they have their own deals for the convention. And but I'll give you a little bit more on I'll give you more ideas a little later on how you can organize yourself. But here is one of the big ones. Another big one is Becca, and here they just have all of the curriculum and you can look through everything, and depending, you can order your stuff here or you can just do it online. But you see all the curriculum is laid out per age group. Another big one is BJU Press. We actually use this for English and writing. So like I said, they have their own show special, so you can get 20% off all BJU Press products. This is my absolute favorite place to shop at the convention. It's called Miller Pads and Paper, and they have so many things. So they have all of these, like what was, what is, art supplies and things so you can do games at home. I mean, there's so much here. They have these plain books so they can make their own comic book, a gratitude journal. This is cursive practice and it's super simple. A nature book, state book. So cool. My favorite place. Like empty sketchbooks. See, bear books. Like this is empty right here. Okay guys, it is day two of the homeschool convention and I wanted to touch base on a couple things. I've been here for a little bit. One thing I forgot to mention is that this homeschool convention has a bunch of workshops. So you've got like a list of workshops that you can choose from, and they all stem from having toddlers to having high school graduates. So it varies, and there's something for everybody. And those are one of the reasons why we love coming to this convention, There are obviously other homeschool conventions you can attend. This is not the only one. This was the first one we attended, so we fell in love with it right away, and so that's why we come every year. So let me just tell you about this convention. This is the Great Homeschool Convention, which I mentioned earlier. They go to multiple states. I think it's 5 states. It's gonna vary every year, but they do come to California each year. I know they normally go to Texas each year. And each year it's gonna be different speakers and also some of the same. So there's Sarah McKenzie, which I will share her picture right now. I see her every single year. I read her book, Teaching from Rest, every year before I start our new school year, even though I school all through summer, but that's a whole nother conversation. but yeah, so every year they're gonna have different people here. So every year you're getting something different. It's not the same thing, which is one reason why we really like it. So let's now talk about some common misconceptions about homeschool. I think the biggest one is going to be that you cannot teach your own child. That is totally false. I know that people get worried. They're like, well, I don't even have a college degree. And though my husband and I do have college degrees, a lot of our friends at homeschool do not. And they're amazing at homeschooling. So it doesn't necessarily mean that you can't do it. Do we have like things that we may have learned in college that have helped us? Yeah, but it's not necessary, and that shouldn't be something that's stopping you from homeschooling. You would be surprised at the resources that are out there for homeschool families. There's curriculum that literally tells you everything to say to your child. There's different ways to homeschool, and I think that's why I love this convention so much. It's because you get to hear all these different ways, and you realize it doesn't have to look like a normal school day, and that you're not teaching for 8 hours, you guys. A lot of the school system, though you learn a lot, I'm not saying that you don't, is slightly babysitting. You drop them off early and pick them up, and they're just filling the time. So you realize that when you're like, okay, it's been like 30 minutes and I'm done, and you're like, all right, then I guess we're done. And it's a weird feeling, but when you finally settle into that, it really does put you at ease, because your homeschool doesn't have to look like a regular school. And I even heard one of the speakers today was saying, why do we compare ourselves to the public school system when we're not trying to be like the public school system, but yet we're still measuring them up to that? And that brings me to my next point. So one thing that's really great about homeschooling is that your children can go at their own pace. And I think when you hear somebody say that, it feels like it means like that means you're taking everything slow, and that's not what that means. What that means is that, for example, let's just say multiplication, your child gets it within a week's time, and you know they got it, you move on. You don't have to spend any more time on multiplication. Yeah, you may put in a little bit of review here, a little bit of review there, but that's it. That's, you're done. And then you move on to the next math thing, or take a break from math. You get to spend more time on something. If they're having a hard time with spelling, then that's what you get to spend time on, and you learn unique ways how to help them with spelling. I remember our oldest son, he would always get the number 12 and 22 mixed up, and I would get so frustrated. Like, how do you not know the difference? And I thought randomly of a game with post-its where he had to like jump on the numbers. And after he played that game, it like the light bulb went off and he got it. And it was one of the most amazing feelings. And that's one of the benefits of homeschool. Not only do you get to take time when you need to, skip over things when you need to, but you get to see the light bulbs go off on your children. And it's the most spectacular thing that you can see. Okay, so I don't want to spend the entire time lecturing. Let's get back inside, go check out some vendor booths. And then we'll get back to some more misconceptions and some information. Quickly, let's talk about the vendors. The Great Homeschool Convention is a Christian convention for Christian homeschoolers, though they do have vendors here that are not associated with any like religious organization. So it's fun to see, like, sometimes Medieval Times is here, sometimes Knott's Berry Farm is here, though I haven't seen them here this year. But you'll have like music schools, or you'll have like sports organizations, like stuff like that. And that's really fun to see, because it allows you to see what's available in your area. And so that's what you're seeing when I'm showing the exhibit hall. I keep calling it the vendor hall, but it's called an exhibit hall. And sometimes a lot of the speakers or the workshops are vendors. Though, yeah, they'll try to like share their curriculum or their program or whatever at the end. But before that, for like, you know, a good 50 minutes, they're talking about something that can help you as a homeschool parent. So that's something I forgot to touch base on. So now let's go check out the exhibit hall again. This guy's always here every year, and it's a hit with the kids. Another one of the big companies. So this is what I'm talking about, specialty exhibitors. You have a violin player for violin lessons. So I wanted to show you these guys. This is called Trail Life, and it's kind of like the Boy Scouts, but Christian based. And they have, I don't know if they call them troops, all over. So they have this activity section every year, and it's so much fun. Yesterday, our oldest son made some ropes. So this is always a fun booth to stop at. Okay, let's talk about the difference between charter and not charter. So depending on the reason why you choose to homeschool, you can either do a charter or you cannot do a charter. What the charter is basically, it's government money, and you are able to use that money for curriculum and other, just other activities. Depending on what kind of curriculum, by law, you are not able to purchase any Christian curriculum with the state money. And you cannot, depending on your co-op, which I'll explain what a co-op is. You cannot use that money to pay for your co-op. So you just have to look at like the rules of like what you're doing. Another thing about charter is you need to meet with you have a representative with your school district, and you need to meet with them, I think it's once a month, turn in paperwork, and they sign you off. When you do not use a charter, you do not have to do that. We do still have to turn in grades and reports, but we don't have to show them our work, which really allows us to take our time throughout the year. So we do have a co-op. It is so windy. I hope you can hear me. sorry, somebody was passing by, so I had to stop. But a co-op is basically like a group that you meet with. It's a lot of times once a week or twice a week, and we do ours through our church, but they have some in the community. I will say it is difficult to find co-ops. I haven't found a place where I can just like search like homeschool co-ops. And so that's something I'm still working on figuring out, like how to do that. But we do, our co-op is through our church, and we meet every Friday throughout the school year, and they have classes they can take. It's really beneficial for the high school kids when they need to do a science, or like one of our homeschool moms has her master's, and she was a teacher at Cal Baptist University, and so she teaches high school English. So there's like stuff like that, but it just kind of depends. And they also do all our government paperwork for us, which is really, I think, the benefit of doing a co-op. But you are able to do it all by yourself. And we have, oh, here's another motorcycle. It's called the HSLDA, and they are also a Christian organization, but they are a legal organization. So there's a lot of motorcycles. If you have a question about homeschooling in your own state, that's a great place to start looking in regards to the laws and the things that you need to do if you don't want to go through anybody, and if you want to do it all for yourself. So I'm going to end this type of conversation, because I really want you guys to see the convention and kind of see what it's about. But if you have any questions about homeschooling, feel free to leave them in the comments, or you can email me, or you can message me on Instagram. I'm happy to share any information I have. And you know, we love it. We love it. We love the freedom. You know, there's so much you can do. And yeah, and also really fast, this is the last thing I want to say. People think that when you homeschool, you have a lot of money, and that is not the case. There is actually a lot of free curriculum you can get online. So if finances are an issue, do some research, and there's a lot of free resources for you. So, all right, guys, let's get back to the convention.
I was exhausted. The only reason I went to Bible study is because they had free childcare and coffee. The Bible is good too, but I get there.
All right, we are on day 3 of the homeschool convention. The last couple videos were of a couple of the workshops, so I'm gonna show you guys the booklet that they gave us. And so you can see what kind of workshops they offer and just how many workshops they offer. They give you this at the beginning, and I do appreciate that it's printed, because I know people don't like printed things, but I still need things printed. So it has, you know, sponsors and here's the first day. So the first day, they have different tracks here. And then you have all the days, and then it starts at 1:30. Then everything starts at 2:30, and it basically goes an hour, then a 30-minute break, an hour, 30-minute break, and that's how it goes throughout the entire thing. And then you have it ending at 8, basically. And then this year, they did, usually they have special ticketed events, and by that I mean it's only maybe $1 for the tickets per person. And this year, all the extra end of night stuff was included. So the first night was Raising Virtuous Rebels with John and Rebecca Lovell. And then this year, what they had, they actually had morning devotion and hymn time with Steve Demi. So that was new this year, but everything started at 8 and 8:30, and it went all day Friday. These are all the workshops. And then it ended last night at about 6:30, and then at 7 they had a comedian. And then this morning started again at about 8:30, and it will go till 5:30. So it's a pretty comprehensive convention, conference. We always say that it feels like a retreat when we don't bring our kids, but yeah. And then you can purchase all the recorded sessions. And yeah, and then there's a map, a list of all of the people exhibiting, and anyways,
Yeah, so that's what you get here.
So I'm thinking next up, we're probably gonna go live inside the exhibit hall. And so the next videos you're gonna see, possibly, are going to be from the lives, since we're gonna stop at the vendors that we like and we think are interesting and kind of different. You know, because as you were seeing throughout the video, you saw that there were like these big homeschool, they're like big homeschool companies that sell curriculum. And actually some private schools use this curriculum for their classrooms. But I will say this about curriculum. I think there's a common misconception is that you have to go through the entire curriculum. And I'm going to tell you, I only know one person that makes it through all of their curriculum. And of course, I'm close to them, so it's a struggle sometimes. I barely get through curriculum. So that's something don't freak out about. Because I do want to show you a curriculum. I want to show you, I think, some of the curriculum in there and like flip through. But anyway, I think this is another video. So I'll do that another day to kind of go through that kind of stuff. But anyways, again, from our live, so it's going to sound a little different, not so like I'm doing a video, but I'm talking to people in the chat kind of video. So, all right, guys.
Homeschool at the YMCA, how cool. Oh, cool. Look at, so the YMCA assists you with homeschooling, engaging classes, family field trips, community events, 10% off a drone class. I want to take a drone class. Great. So yeah, Ace, this could be considered sports or like activities. Look at that. So I think it's interesting how like you don't realize that a lot of the organizations we already know about, they actually help out with homeschooling, which is super cool. And yeah, we've had passes for the YMCA before. Isn't that cool?
Oh, look at, they can make comic books. Oh,
they're like taught like everything, like how to make a story and everything, and it's actually published and everything.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And is it like classes they could take?
Yes, it's a class you can take.
Do they have to have prerequisites in any way?
I'm not sure. I don't think so.
Okay, culinary kids. We were just saying that.
Look at that. Cooking class for kids. Comic book writing for kids. Math, Lego. Awesome. Sign language and deaf culture. How awesome.
We teach them.
Sign language and deaf culture class for K through 3 or 4 through 8.
Even though they're only making a comic.
And this is at the Fullerton YMCA.
Character development. Then they do.
Oh, awesome. How about field trips? Look at that. Where do you guys go for field trips?
Different places. We do like, we're going to do medieval times coming up.
Oh, yes. I love medieval times.
Oh, my gosh. We'll fill this out and put in not only field trips, but say that you want to do the field trip. We're signing the email list.
Okay. Do you know if there's any YMCAs in other states?
Oh, yeah. There.
Somebody's watching our, we're doing a YouTube video.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And they're asking if you guys have them in Texas.
Texas?
YMCAs, but I don't know about homeschool programs. We're just starting these homeschool
programs. So Nicole, she says they have YMCAs in Texas, but she doesn't know if they have like the homeschool programs like this. Curriculum-based learning, academic and enrichment electives, PE electives. Okay. So yeah, they totally do physical activity for the kids. Swimming, study hall, lunch and social hour, community, friendships, experience, YMCA teachers, and so much more. That's cool. Okay, guys, these are awesome here.
Oh, that's fine.
These are called read aloud posters. So check it out, guys. You choose a book like Charlotte's Web. So you pick a book like Charlotte's Web, and then they make these posters that are totally interactive. So as you read the book with your kid, you get to build like a little piece that goes along and you place it on the board in different places throughout the book. It's got different places where like you write things in as you read. There's, this is Anatomy of a Spider, spider facts. There's like all kinds, and like the whole thing is real custom. So she was telling us about it yesterday. We're like, throughout the whole book, you're pretty much filling in this thing and coloring it with your kiddo, and it just kind of covers all kinds of activities and things that your kid can learn with as you read the book. So we're gonna start it with this book called The Wild Robot. We're getting the book, and we bought this poster yesterday. So we're gonna hopefully go through the book together with our boy and or both boys. And she was saying the kiddos love it, and they asked, you know, when are we gonna do our next chapter for the book? Because they love filling out this thing as you read. So we're stoked for it. So this company, guys, is called Ruby Reads. You can go to the website rubyreadsbooks.com. So yeah, we're pretty stoked to try this one here for the Wild Robot. And she told us they're coming out with a movie for the book this fall or this winter. So that'll be cool to read the book, to fill this thing out. It's got all kinds of interaction, and then we'll see the movie when it comes out too. So super cool. Again, her company's called rubyreadsbooks.com. Look at this, guys. The Hobbit. Are you kidding me? And look at this. If you're a C.S. Lewis fan, they've got The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe.
Yes. So I would just give you the...
Telling you guys. See what I mean? Everyone's custom. And so it's got so many different pieces, like almost to the puzzle as you read it. A Secret Garden. Yesterday we bought the one for The Wild Robot. Again, they're going to come out with a movie this winter. And then My Two Cents says we need The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe by C.S. Lewis. And then, of course, after that, we're going to need to read The Hobbit.
Right, I'll see it because I'm going to leave the poster.
Yeah, so this idea of reading aloud to your kids is huge. And I think it's awesome because they enjoy it. We're like, either they're reading aloud or like just as a family, you sit and one of the parents reads aloud. And then again, to have this thing that provides activity to where you can learn vocabulary words and scenery and like... She was saying on the Wild Robot one that we bought, it comes with this little thing. It's almost like a little cardboard thing that you create. You actually build this little cardboard robot, and then it goes onto the thing, and then as you read the book, the robot travels along the different spots. So we will see. Hopefully it's super helpful.
And I love your
head. Again, her company is called Ruby Reads. You'd find her at rubyreadsbooks.com.
All right, so I wanted to talk about one thing before I finish it off, and it was how I go about kind of planning before I come, because you can easily get super overwhelmed. So what I do, I remember my first year, my friend said, "Now don't go buy everything," and I said, okay, I'm not gonna, and that was like the best advice because I would have just bought everything. And so now what I do, I mean, I've been coming for 6 years and I still feel completely unorganized. But what I started doing the last couple years is kind of figuring out, I know it's hard because it's June, right? So I know for some homeschool families, like they're still going and they're not even really sure what they want to do next year. That's okay, I will say. But when you come here and you look at the exhibit hall, make sure you know what you're looking for. So let's, for example, I already know the math I want to use, the English I want to use, the science, kind of. So for example, I was looking for science and history, and also going to that Miller paper and pads, seeing anything that would accompany the things that I'm doing for this next coming year. One thing I was looking for was I knew he wants to learn anatomy, but I didn't want it to be all complicated. So I was looking for something that was more his age appropriate. The book I was originally going to get, I saw in a catalog, from christianbooks.com, and I'm so glad they had it here, because I looked through and I'm like, this is like a high school textbook. Like, this is not for a nine-year-old. So I didn't get that, but I did end up finding kind of like more of like, I showed it in the live, and I'll show you it here. I'll cut it from the live, but I ended up choosing that and then finding it on Amazon for like 10 bucks or something. And so that's what I'm gonna do for anatomy. And then for history, I didn't know what I wanted. I know I wanna do the California missions, because he's gonna be in fourth grade and I'm gonna have him make a mission. But I couldn't find anything California, but I knew I still wanted to do history with him. So I found his history. And then as we were leaving, I found a vendor that did like playing cards, like history playing cards. And I was like, oh, those are perfect for like when we're on road trips, which we tend to do a lot. And so I got like a medieval history one, which I will show right now. And so before you come, make a list of what you're looking for, things you might be interested in getting, so that you don't overspend. And kind of like when you get here, you kind of get inspired, and that can be a super fault because then you'll buy everything. So come the first night. This is why I suggest you come the entire convention, because if you only come on Thursday, you just buy everything because you're only coming Thursday for the free shopping event. But if you come all the whole 3 days, then you're able to see something the first day. Okay, turn back around, go maybe check it out the second day. Then the last day, you really know if you really want it. So that's my suggestion to you. Whatever homeschool convention you go to, make a list. Whether you fulfill that list or not, at least you know, because there's deals at the convention, at the conference. I don't know what to call it, conference, convention. It feels like a conference because of the workshops, but it's a convention because they have the exhibit hall. So that's my suggestion to you, whether you go to this homeschool convention, another one, or even when you're looking online and doing a general search, make sure you kind of know what you want. And I'm not talking about like, I know I want history 101. Like, no, like, okay, you're looking for history, fine. What kind of history? Look that up. Math. See, there's a lot of free math, so check those out, you know. So anyways, that's my suggestion to you guys. All right, everybody, that will do it at the Great Homeschool Convention. Make sure you guys like and subscribe to Cat Family Adventures for more adventures and videos like this. And if you missed our live, I will link it below in the description. So if you guys have any questions on anything you saw on the live, anything you saw here, anything I said on this vlog, please feel free to message me, email me, DM me. I'm happy to answer any questions. I obviously don't know everything, but I am happy to tell you what I know and send you off to a location that might know. But thank you again for watching, and we appreciate you all being here, and we will see you on our next adventure. Bye, guys. God bless you.